Scotland's always special to play. I think that was the first place we ever did a tour when I was about 17, and ever since that day, every time we've gone up there to play, the audience is amazing. The enthusiasm that they bring, just the passion, really. My biggest dream is what I'm doing now, playing around the world, playing shows. Hanging out with cool people who love to write music as well. You get to see a lot of your friends in different cities. Once you've played a show, yeah, you get to hang out with your mates on the tour bus and have a good laugh.
You said we could take a break because it's moving too fast. I said I can hardly wait to see how long it can last. You said you could not imagine all the pain that I've seen. I said you don't understand the way your heart of my dream. I can take a tumble to the side of the road.
There's a few songs you usually add into a set list before each tour, so you want to make sure you play those right. So there's a few nerves, but you start to settle down after 2 or 3 days in. Grew up in Clifton, just outside Nottingham. I'm proud to come from there. In terms of influence of my music, I never really wanted to be like anyone. A lot of my favourite artists, they were who they were because they were themselves. You know, I love Johnny Cash, and Tammy Wynette is a great singer. The Kinks, you've got, there's the Beatles. Everyone wanted to be Jimi Hendrix, but no one ever will. But yeah, I wish I could see more shows, but we spend quite a lot of time playing them. It's hard to catch everyone you want to see. Try and be in a zone of not overthinking, not being conscious, but not on autopilot either. Gotta find that balance on stage. Once you get on the stage, everything that you felt before goes out the windows. You know, the adrenaline takes over and you pick up the guitar and you're away, and it's an amazing experience. Intimate shows to festivals. Some of those songs I'd written, you know, in my bedroom at 15, 16 years old. To be hear them singing back at you 10 years later is it's quite hard to describe, to be honest. I think my younger self would be very happy trying to devote my life to music. It's something that I always wanted, and it's something I'm lucky enough to be able to do. A childhood dream and a hobby that turned into something quite serious. I'd like to say guitar music is coming back, but honestly, I don't think it is. It's very rare that you get a guitar to be the main instigator for the melody line or hooks in a song now. At the end of the day, for me, it's about songs. Whether that be playing on a guitar or a synthesizer, Yeah, of course, it's always nice to hear a little lick in a solo every now and again. It's not about how well you sing, how well you play, it's about how good the song is, how that connects with people. And there's going to be days that you can't put a good few chords together and you can't get it right, and it's really frustrating. But you just got to keep driving at it. Don't try and force it. Those barriers do come down again. You know, it's everywhere you go, music. You get in a lift, you turn on the television, whatever, it's everywhere. And what it creates inside people, how it makes them feel, what they get back from it, and how they interpret lyrics or a song and helps them in some way. I think that's an amazing thing and definitely something worth doing it for. We were never meant to free.